gonna hurt. Oh!
On a school watch tonight, a physics teacher in Watsonville took acceleration and velocity to new heights today. Did it with potatoes. Class at Monte Vista Christian got to see how far they could launch a potato. Action News reporter Michelle Amparato was there and has more on today's unique physics lesson.
I'm here at Monte Vista Christian School in Watsonville, where one of the 12th grade classes is getting a lesson in physics, and it's a lesson they won't soon forget.
The sounds of spuds catapulting into the sky fill the air.
Oh. The rules is it needs to be a trebuchet or a catapult, and they need to launch a potato. To get full credit, they need to launch it 35 meters.
Mr. Dauphin knew there was no better way to teach his physics class a lesson about acceleration and velocity than for them to get hands-on, a tradition here at Monte Vista Christian School. Most of the mechanisms were constructed of wood, but everyone's designs were unique.
I'm always surprised with all the creativity that comes. You know, some catapults look traditional, some catapults are brand new, some work and some don't, but it's great for the kids to get creative to try and solve a problem.
Dawson Bean admits he made his catapult with his dad in just about a day and a half, okay. But he still came out the winner of his class, launching his potato an impressive 46 meters.
I learned to give it a lot of time because it was kind of a last minute project, but also I learned that just kind of more about physics and how long I should have things in the ratios between stuff.
Kayla Traber made her catapult out of wood and her father's exercise weights. Her potato hit the 36 meter mark, which earned her the mark she was looking for, an A. But she says she definitely learned a lesson, and if she had to do it again, she'd make some changes to her design.
If I could do something differently, I'd definitely add weights to the base of mine, so energy wouldn't be lost going forward in it.
Now in the springtime, Mr. Dauphin's physics class will have another hands-on lesson like this one. The students will have to build boats using nothing but cardboard and duct tape, and they'll have to successfully sail from one side of the school's pool to the other. In Watsonville, Michelle Imperato, KSBW, Action News 8.